Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Praise be to Allah alone. We all praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one. And whomsoever Allah leaves astray, no one can show him guidance. I send the best peace and blessings upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome you once again with another segment talking about the fifth pillar of Islam, which is Hajj. Very interesting act of worship. This is where Muslims are invited to visit Allah's house. When we say Allah's house, it does not mean this is a place where God lives in it, because Allah is beyond any space or any room. Allah is the greatest. But Allah has ordered His prophet Abraham and his son Ishmael to build this ancient house, Al-Kaaba. It was said that it was built first by Prophet Adam, peace be upon him. But in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. In the second chapter of the Quran, Allah says, remember when Ibrahim and his son Ismail have raised the foundations of the house, the Kaaba, which is known as the Kaaba, the ancient house. And when they finished, they said, our Lord, accept this work from us. You are the all-hearer, the all-knowing. رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. When they finished the construction of the Kaaba and building the house, they made dua to keep the Muslims, to make from their offspring Muslims, and to show them the rites of Hajj, how to perform Hajj and Umrah. Hajj, once per lifetime, is mandatory on every Muslim who can afford it. Allah the Almighty says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. To Allah, upon mankind, the duty of performing Hajj to the ancient house for those who can afford the means. Al-istita'a and the capability refers to if he is physically fit and can travel, and also if he has a financial means to cover the journey of Hajj. What if they can? Then they're exempt. If somebody financially well off and he can go, can spend to go for Hajj, but he can't afford it physically because of disability or insecurity or whatever, then he's required to send somebody to perform Hajj in his stead, provided that person must have performed his or her own Hajj first. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself performed only one Hajj, which is known as the farewell Hajj. And in this Hajj he said, O people, Allah have ordained Hajj on you, so perform Hajj. One of the audience said, O Prophet of Allah, do we have to do it every year? Because look, the ibadat, as-salah, you have to do it 5 times a day. As-zakah, once a year. Fasting, once a year. The mandatory fasting. He said, do we have to perform Hajj every year as well? The Prophet ﷺ neglected his question. But the guy repeated the question 3 times. Finally, the Prophet ﷺ remarked, saying, have I said yes, it would have been mandatory to perform Hajj every year, and you cannot afford it. Allah made it easy for us. مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. So this is as far as Hajj. What about Umrah? Umrah is a visit to the ancient house of the Hajj season, because the Hajj has certain times. It's got to be offered at a certain time, where on the 9th day of the month of Dhul Hijjah, which is the last month in the lunar and Islamic calendar, the 9th day, all the pilgrims must be present in one valley. In one valley which is known as the Valley of Arafah. And it is known Arafah, the word Arafah, like knowing each other. We get to meet each other. Literally, you see a rainbow color. You see people from all different colors, backgrounds, and mother tongues, different ethnicities. Amazing. That is the only religion which summons this diverse background. And this is the greatest multinational in background annual meeting. You see people rich and poor, presidents, guards, extremely rich, extremely poor, everybody's dressed up in the same fashion. The ihram. The ihram, which is the outfit which we wear as men in the Hajj, requires us to get rid of any stitched clothes. Anything other than the izar and the rida, two towels. That which you see in the videos, men wear two towels. One they place on their shoulders and one as an izar, they wrap it around their waist. And that's it. Well, that reminds us with the moment when we were born. Whenever we see the baby, just a sheet or a towel, we wrap him or her up in it. Correct. And also at the time of death, the coffin or the shroud. Correct. So Hajj is also is to remind us with the fact that life is short and brief, and there will be a day on which Allah will summon all of us, the very first and the very last. And no matter how much you have or possess in this life, no matter what kind of occupation do you occupy, your position, your status in the community, you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala naked without any of that. Allah doesn't look at your richness, at your bodies, at your positions or positions, rather He looks at your hearts. If the hearts are pure, if the person is sincere, this is what really counts. That will determine your status before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With regards to the virtues of performing Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة. Whoever performs Hajj properly and his Hajj will be accepted, its reward is straightforward to go to Jannah, to paradise. And as far as the Umrah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما مجتنبت الكبائر. Performing Umrah after another Umrah is an expiation for whatever sins were committed in between, as long as you avoid the major sins. It seems like when we go for Hajj, we spend money, true, and make effort, yes. But guess what? Allah promises to give a replacement and a compensation for those who go for Hajj, since the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, follow up in performing Hajj and Umrah because they remove poverty and sins. They remove poverty and sins. Allah give you a replacement for what you spend for His sake in order to perform a Hajj. It's very interesting to know that when you go for Hajj, you have to prepare yourself mentally, not only physically, but also spiritually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-Hajju ashhurun ma'lumat, faman farada fihinna al-hajj fala rafatha wala fusuqa wala jidala fil hajj. Whenever you go for Hajj, avoid talking ill talk. Zip off your mouth. Do not say but good things. Do not do any sins. Even while in a state of ihram, it is not permissible for one to approach his or her spouse sexually because they are in a state of purity or ihram. So once again, we abstain from the halal because Allah said so. Then it's a lot easier to abstain from the haram. Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in this regard, من حج فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه. If you perform Hajj properly and you avoid all kind of sins and you avoid having intimate relationship with your spouse while in a state of ihram, so your Hajj was perfect, you shall return home as the same day you were born. In what sense? Pure and sinless. Hajj will make the person reborn. That's why even though Hajj is ordained once per lifetime, people are very eager to do Hajj more than once. People are very eager to spend their annual vacation in going for Umrah or Hajj. They go to visit Allah's house. They get their sins forgiven. And meanwhile, they pile up mountains of good deeds. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one prayer in my masjid is better than offering 1,000 prayer anywhere else. You know, the prophetic masjid is in Al-Madinah, while the Kaaba is in Mecca. If you visit Al-Madinah to pray in the Prophet's masjid, each prayer is better than 1,000 prayer anywhere else, except in Al-Masjid Al-Haram. Because each prayer in the Kaaba, in Al-Masjid Al-Haram in Mecca, is better than 100,000 prayers anywhere else. May Allah invite us all to perform Hajj and Umrah and expiate our sins and accept from us the best of our deeds. brothers and sisters, it was a great pleasure to be with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this humble effort from all of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.